Yeah, so thank you so much for joining the session. Today, we are going to talk about the power of digital identities, how you can leverage digital identity to strengthen your fraud prevention in real time, as well as provide good frictionless customer experience to your customers. When we talk about digital, it has been embedded in our life completely now. Everything we do as individuals finds its way into digital world. From communicating with our friends, doing banking, buying groceries, even education can be done online today. As per the latest study by Nokia, an average Indian spends 5 hours a day online, either through his smartphone or through his desktop or laptop. When we do that, we leave a lot of digital footprints behind on the web. And these footprints actually help create a digital identity. So today we are going to talk about a case study where we have helped a bank. It's a real case study where we have helped a bank deal with online frauds on their digital channel. So let me just give you a brief perspective how we help. So basically, they use our threat matrix solution, which is an enterprise risk enterprise solution for digital identity intelligence and digital authentication that is trusted by more than 5,000 global brands, and it is embedded in more than 40,000 websites and mobile apps across the world. What Threat Matrix does is basically it provides a historic context which helps in detecting misuse of a user account. Threat Matrix builds a comprehensive digital identity, and the digital identity network which is crowdsourced from all of our customers actually sees through 55 billion transactions in a year. And all these transactions are new account opening, logins, as well as a new account creation. And this is not a point solution which is only being used by bank. It cuts across multiple industries. It has users in e-commerce, it has users in traveling website. So with the help of this solution, we were able to help this bank prevent fraudulent money transfers worth 350,000 USD. So let's talk about which bank we are talking about. This is Kudos Bank from Australia. This is one of the largest mutual bank in Australia. It has more than 1 lakh members. It was started in 1959 by Qantas employees, Qantas Airlines employees, as Qantas Credit Union, and it got rebranded as Kudos Bank in 2016. The asset size for this bank at this moment of time is 4.5 billion USD. And this bank, the bank's positioning is that this is the bank you can rely on for at any time of your life. The customer is at the heart of processes, services, or banking products from this bank. In 2018, this bank struggled with online frauds, and there were stiff challenges they had to overcome. So let's go to the next slide and understand what were those challenges. So for Kudos Bank, customers were being targeted by different methods or scams. In my personal opinion, the customer is becoming the weakest link in the cybersecurity. In Kudos Bank, fraudsters were actually increasingly targeting customers to by social engineering to make them do fraudulent money transfers or divulge their credentials. So what are the ways by which they were doing it? First was phishing. So in phishing, there were multiple schemes. There were they were tricking customers by promising a guaranteed job, a high-paying job, in lieu of some money to be transferred to the fraudster. The second type of scheme where you know they were socially engineered, they were using social engineering to lure customer in downloading malwares or remote access trojans in their devices. The other peculiar or key phenomena which we have observed in India also, which is called SIM swap. The other name for it is phone porting also. So how it was troubling Fidos Bank was their customers, you know, once they share their credentials with fraudsters, then fraudsters were, mimicking their identity, and they would go to telecom service providers for the customer, and then they would, request for porting the SIM to a different network or issue a new SIM. So all of this had resulted in huge fraud losses for Kudos Bank and in the, the trust between customer and bank as well, right? So the Kudos Bank struggled, and the biggest challenge at that point of time for them was how do they prevent these type of frauds in real time? That is when the chief risk officer of Qantas Bank, Enter Shine, called for a fraud framework review. As part of the review process, they identify the weaknesses and they contemplated on how could they strengthen the internal controls to stop these frauds. And they came to a conclusion that they would want to use technology to protect their customers, protect their bank's reputation. So Enter approached ThreatMetrix. And they actually were not looking for a point solution. They were looking for a solution which could provide them intelligence from not only from banking but other industries as well. And the solution was expected to help them optimizing their fraud strategy. So now let's take one step back and first identify how do we create digital identity. So in the middle, you are seeing there is an individual. So this is basically a digital identity map or graphical representation of an individual. There are a lot of other data attributes, components which are there, which is related to device, shipping address, phone number. So what happens in our network is when a customer comes in our network, we create a digital identity, and in that digital identity, we also connect other attributes in our channel, what mail ID he has used, what devices he has used, what shipping address has been mentioned, all that. And all this information is anonymized. You can see there are certain attributes with which digital identity has linkages with thin line. Some of the lines are thicker. So that shows the thicker lines are for the attributes which have seen more frequently with this particular user in our digital identity network. The second component of digital identity is the location. What are the usual location for customer from where he is logging in? You check it through the IP addresses, Wi-Fi IPs, or GPS on the devices. This actually shows the activity pattern as well. Just think of a session or a customer request coming from Delhi at 9 a.m. After half an hour, this request seems to be coming from Mumbai. Is it possible for a customer to travel to Mumbai in half an hour's time? Or is it a fraudster or somebody is trying to hide the true location? So digital identity intelligence can actually pierce through VPN, Tor browser, and give you the true location of the user. The other important aspect is how do you link all these information to give you an indication of user behavior, online user behavior for this particular digital identity. Last but not the least is threat analytics. So what is the risk category or what is the risk score for this digital identity? Is this digital identity trying to always wipe the cookies, hide their location, they are coming from a VPN, or are they behaving in a manner a fraudster would behave? Just to give you an example, somebody has to type his username on an internet website, he's not going to do a copy paste. Copy paste may be done by a fraudster who had got a lot of username and passwords from dark web or from a data breach. Now let's identify how this digital identity map would look for an account where the credential has been compromised. Now this particular case is where you can see a digital identity which has a high correlation with a device, but there are more than 8 or 9 devices which are trying to log in with the credential of this digital identity user with different email IDs. So this is a clear case example where the digital identity credential has been compromised or the account has been taken over by fraudsters, and fraudsters are trying to get access to the account from multiple devices. On the other right hand side, you can see the relationship view. So we as a provider or creator of digital identity, we also give you a view how the data attributes within digital identity correlate with each other. Let's try and identify how does how do fraudsters move in their pursuit of fraud or avenues for fraud. So this is a classic example from our digital identity network again. 3rd January 2019, this particular fraudster has created multiple accounts in a media streaming company. For example, just say Netflix. Now he moves to try to log into his bank account, Bank A. During this process, we continuously block his transactions in the bank, but he never stops. He goes from Bank A to Bank B, then he goes to a credit reference agency, and then he moves on. They keep coming back. They would always look for new avenues for fraud. So how do we map the digital journey for banks so that we protect the transaction at each and every touch point in the digital journey, be it account opening, be it payments, be it user account activities, management activities which users do by adding beneficiary, changing mobile. If you capture or if you enable the solution at every point of these multiple touch points, you are actually creating a robust mechanism and not giving an opportunity to fraudster to perpetrate fraud. Now, going back to Kudos Bank, in 2018, Kudos Bank implemented our threat matrix solution. They empowered their fraud framework with LexisNexis digital identity. Now what they are doing is they are actually using device intelligence in terms of the devices being used by the customers. They are also using physical identity as well as digital identity attributes like username, address, email address, and they are also piercing through the true location of the customers. And then the other key component is the threat analytics. So they are checking if the devices from which customers are logging in are infected with any malware or remote access trojans, or the traffic which is coming to their internet banking or mobile banking, is it a bot which is sending the traffic, or it is a human being, or a human being or a fraudster is using a device simulator on the desktop and it is being represented as if the traffic is coming from a mobile app on a mobile. So all of this they are using to consume it in the dynamic decision platform with the help of smart rules. Now all this intelligence is helping them distinguish fraudsters in real time from good customers. Also, they are able to provide trust checks to their existing customers who are genuine customers. Now these trust checks are actually binding the device with users. And for these users or these good returning customers, they are providing frictionless experience by not asking them OTP, SMSs, or any other way of second level of authentication. So So quickly coming to the benefits. So benefit for Kudos Bank where, you know, they were able to protect frauds, they were protect the customer trust, and they were reduce their fraud losses. This also resulted in operational efficiency for the customer because they were getting less customer complaints and they became agile, and with ThreatMetrix, they were able to detect the full spectrum of scam, not only the scams they were targeted for in 2018. So this is a word of encouragement from Enter. Fraudsters never stop innovating. They keep finding new ways or modus operandi to target customers. Why should we stop innovating? With ThreatMetrix, Kudos Bank has the intelligence and industry expertise to anticipate and prepare for certain trends or attacks. Then they can use these solutions to deploy and see if that attack pattern is in wild.